Hello friends, welcome you in my channel Science and All. In this video we are going to start with theory of machines and we are going to learn about links, lower joints, higher joints and also we are going to find out the degree of freedoms of various mechanisms. So start with basic. So what is links? As we know that we have seen various types of mechanism and we have seen that there are various members present in that mechanism and these members transmit the power from one end to the other end. So these members are nothing but links, lower joints. So when the two members or say two links are connected to each other, so when the two links are connected to each other, the contact which is made between the two members is if surface contact or a link contact, then we can call that contact or say that joint as a lower joint. So lower joint is nothing but a surface contact or member contact. Higher joint. So higher joint is formed when a one body, let's say a cylinder or a circular body, is in contact with the horizontal plane surface, then the contact which was made between the cylinder and the horizontal surface is line contact. So when the contact between the two bodies is in the form of line contact or say is in the form of point contact, then that joint or contact we can call it as higher joint. So hope you understand the concept. Now when two are links are connected to each other, that joint is called as binary joint or say binary links. When three links, we call it as tertiary links, are connected to each other, then the joints made between the three links are two joints. So two joints are made when three links are connected to each other. When three or four links are connected to each other, then there are three joints are made. Now let's discuss from the following diagrams, you can easily determine how many links or how many lower joints or higher joints are present in the mechanism. So here you can see that there is a fixed member present in the diagram mechanism. So this is first link. So we can call the fixed member as a first link. This is our second link. This is our third link. And this is our fourth link. So there are all total four links are present in the mechanism. So the number of links are four. Now as we say that if there is a surface contact or the member contact between the two members or links, then we can call it as lower joint. So let's find out. So here you can see that there is a one object present or say a link is connected to this fixed member, that is other link, first link, in the form of surface contact or say member contact. So this is first lower joint. Now link 2 and link 3 are connected to each other, so it is second lower joint. Link 3 and link 4 are connected to each other, so it is third lower joint. And you can see that here the link 4 is connected to the member 1 in the form of point contact. So here you can see that this is a circle or say cylindrical body. So circle is in contact with the fixed member in the form of point contact. So this is higher joint. So called it as first higher joint. So here three lower joints are present and one higher joint are present. So hope you understand how to determine links, lower joint and higher joint. Let's solve one more problem on the same. So here you can see that there is a shaded portion present. So that shaded portion we can call it as first link. Now this is our second link, this is our third link, this is our fourth link, this is our fifth link and this is our sixth link. So there are all total six links are present in the mechanism. Now let's find, so links are 6. the lower joints in the mechanism. So here you can see that this is one link. So this one link is connected to the link 2. So this is our first lower joint. Link 2 is connected to link 3. So this is our second lower joint. Link 3 is connected to link 4, and also link 3 is connected to link 5. So as we have already discussed, when the three links are connected to each other, then there are two joints present. So we can call this joint as two joint, means third lower joint and fourth lower joint. So here two joints are present. Now the fourth link is connected to first link. So here again one lower joint is formed, that is fifth lower joint. Again fifth link is connected to the sixth link. So this is our sixth lower joint, and sixth link is connected to the first link. So this is our seventh lower joint. So there are all total seven lower joints are present. So this is how you can also determine number of lower joints, higher joints and number of links. So here you cannot see that there is no higher joint is present. So this is higher joint is 0. Now let's calculate the degree of freedom in any kind of mechanism. So a Gubler is a scientist who gives a formula to find out the degree of freedom present in any kind of mechanism, and his formula is denoted as degree of freedom is equal to 3 into L minus 1 minus 2J minus H. So where L is link, J is lower joint, and H is higher joint. So by using this formula, we can easily determine the number of degree of freedom. So by using some numericals, let's calculate the degree of freedom of various kinds of mechanism. Let's solve the first numerical. So let's find out number of links, number of lower joints and number of higher joints. So this is the fixed member. So let's call this as fixed link. Let's give it number as 1. This is second link. This is third link. This is fourth link. This is fifth link. So this is connected here. This is sixth link and this is seventh link. So again this is a fixed member, means number 1. So here all total 7 members are present. So links 7. Now let's calculate the lower joint. So this is our first lower joint. This is again second lower joint. This is third lower joint and this is fourth lower joint. Now link 3 and link 2 are connected. So this is our fifth lower joint. Link 2 and link 4 is connected. So this is our sixth lower joint. Link 4, link 5 and link 6 are connected. So here 3 links are connected. Now there are 2 joints are present. So here our 7th lower joint and 8th lower joint. Now link 6 is connected to link 7. So this is our 9th lower joint and this is our 4th lower joint. Now there are all total 9 lower joints are present. Now for the higher joint, we need any kind of point contact or a surface contact or a line contact, but here there is no line contact or point contact, so higher joint is 0. Now let's calculate the degree of freedom. So degree of freedom equal to 3 into L minus 1 minus 2J minus H. So 3 into L is 7 minus 1 minus 2 into 9. So 18 minus 18 equal to 0. So this mechanism has 0 degree of freedom. So in this way you can calculate the degree of freedom. Now let's again solve one more numerical based on the same degree of freedom. Now again calculate the link. So this is link 1, this is link 1, this is link 1. Now this is second link, this is our third link, this is whole complete as considered as fourth link, this is our fifth link, and this is our sixth link. So there are all total 6 links are present. Now this is our first lower joint, this is our second lower joint, this is our third lower joint, link 2 and link 3, so this is our fourth lower joint, link 4 and link 3, so this is our fifth lower joint, link 4 and link 5, so this is our sixth lower joint, link 6 and link 4, so this is our seventh lower joint, and its end. So there are all total 7 lower joints are present. And about higher joint, so here no mechanism is present in line contact or surface contact, so higher contact is 0. Now let's calculate the degree of freedom. So degree of freedom is given by 3 into L minus 1 minus 2J minus H. So H is completely 0. 3 into, let's put the value, 6 minus 1 minus 2 into 7. So 6 minus 1 is 5 and 5 into 3 is 15 minus 14 equal to 1. So degree of freedom comes to be 1. And when the degree of freedom comes to be 1, we can call that mechanism as fully constrained mechanism. So this is fully constrained mechanism. Now let's solve one more numerical on degree of freedom. Let's calculate the links. Now here you can see that there are 4 fixed links are present. So this is our first link. So remember that every time you should number first to the fixed link. Now this is our second link, this is our third link, so it's this is our fourth link connected here. No, this is a complete one link. Okay, this is our fourth link, this is our fifth link, this is our sixth link, and this link is connected to a slider. So this is a slider which moves in this direction and in this direction. So here is also one contact is present, and this is our seventh link. So there are all total 7 links are present. Now let's calculate the lower joint. So this is our first lower joint, this is our second lower joint, this is our third lower joint, and this is our fourth lower joint. Now link 2 and link 3, so this forms one lower joint, that is our fifth lower joint. Link 3 is connected to link 4, so this is our sixth lower joint. Link 5 is connected to link 4, so this is our again link 4, 5 and 6 are 3 links connected at a single point, so they form a tertiary link, means there are 2 joints are present. So let's number them as 7th lower joint and 8th lower joint. Now here again you can see that 6th link is connected to a slider which was present between the two fixed surfaces. So here is also one contact is present, and that contact we also called as lower joint. So this is also a surface contact, and let's number them as a 9th lower joint. Now let's calculate the number of freedom. So degree of freedom is equal to 3 into L minus 1 minus 2 G minus H. So 3 into 7 minus 1 is 6. Here 9 lower joints and 0 higher pair. 6 minus 2 into 9. So here 3 into 6 is 18 minus 2 into 9 is again 18. So degree of freedom comes to be 0. So this mechanism again don't have any kind of degree of freedom. So hope you again understand the how to find links, how to find lower joints, and how to find higher joints. Now let's solve the one numerical where the you can easily determine where is higher joint. Now this is again one more kind of mechanism, as we have already discussed that when the two circles or a circular body in contact with the plane surface, then it form a point contact or say a line contact. So here you can see that a two circles are connected to each other in the form of point contact. So they are forming a point contact, and this contact we call as higher joint. So here one higher joint is present. Now let's calculate the number of link. So this is, as we know, our first link. This is our second link. This is our third link. This is our fourth link, and this is our five link. So there are all total five links are present. Now let's calculate the lower joint. So this is a higher joint. Now the remaining was this one. So here link 1, link 3 and link 4 are connected to each other. Means there are three joints are present. Three links are present, and they form two joints. So let's call it as first lower joint and second lower joint. Again, link 3, link 2 and link 5 are connected to each other, and then we call this joint as our third lower joint and fourth lower joint. Now again link 4 and link 5 are connected, so this is fifth lower joint. So there are all total 5 lower joints are present. Now let's calculate the degree of freedom for this mechanism. Freedom equal to the same formula, 3 into L minus 1 minus 2J minus H. So 3 into 5 minus 1 is 4 minus 2 into 5 minus 1. 12 minus 10 minus 1 comes to be 1. So here the degree of freedom for this mechanism comes to be 1. So this mechanism is again fully constrained mechanism. So hope you understand how to find out higher pair also. So this is our higher pair. Now let's solve one more numerical on finding degree of freedom. If you are able to find out the number of links, number of lower joints, number of higher joints and the degree of freedom from this mechanism, then I will confirm that you will completely understand this video. So start to find out. Now let's solve this numerical. So let's again find out the number of links. So our first preference is giving the links first number to the our fixed link. Now this is our second link. This is our third link. Now this is again one more link. So this is in contact with this in the form of surface. So this is our fourth link. This is our fifth link. This is our sixth link. This is our seventh link. This is our eighth link. This is ninth link and this is tenth link. So I hope you understand how to find out the number of links. So here all total 10 links are present. Now let's calculate the number of lower joints. So here you can see that link 2 is connected to the fixed surface 1. So this is our first lower joint. Now here you can see that link 3 is connected to this surface. So this is our second lower joint. But here you can see that this body is in contact with the fixed surface, but at the point contact, because the circles or the circular body is present in between them. So this is nothing but a higher pair joint. So this is first higher pair joint. So here only one higher pair is present. Now this is our first lower joint. This is our second lower joint. This is third lower joint. This is fourth lower joint. This is fifth lower joint. This is sixth lower joint. This is seventh lower joint. This is eighth lower joint. This is ninth lower joint. This one is tenth lower joint. This one is 11th lower joint. and this one is 12th lower joint. So here all to the 12th lower joint is present. So this is first, this one is second, because link 3 is connected to the this body surface is connected to the fixed surface, but in the form of point contact. So this is our higher pair joint. So this is lower, second lower pair joint. This is third lower joint, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, 11th and 12th. So there are all total 12 lower joints are present. Now we have find out the number of links, number of higher joints and number of lower joints. If you are able to find out these values, then you are perfect in finding out number of links, higher joints and lower joints. Now let's calculate the degree of freedom. So again, our formula by the Gubler's equation, degree of freedom equal to 3 into L minus 1 minus 2 J minus higher pair. So 3 into L is 10 minus 1 minus 2 into 12 minus 1. So 9 into 3, 27 minus 24 minus 1. So this comes out to be 2. So degree of freedom comes to be 2. Now, when the degree of freedom comes to be 2 or say more than 1, then the motion, we call it as unconstrained motion. So this is unconstrained motion. So from this whole diagram or from this whole calculation, we can easily determine or we can easily understand links, higher pair, lower joints and degree of freedom. So from this complete video, hope you understand the basic of theory of machines, that is links, finding of lower pair joint, finding of higher pair joint and the finding of degree of freedom of any kind of mechanism. So now if you have any kind of doubt in this video, please mention that doubt in the comment section below. I will reply to your problem. Again, if you want some more numericals on finding out degree of freedom or finding out links, lower pair joints, higher pair joints, mention down in the comment section. Please subscribe my channel, because I am going to give you more information, more numerically based problems on this kind of subjects. And don't forget to hit the bell icon. Again, thank you for your support for watching this video till the end. Please share this video with your friends so that they will also get the same information. So thank you and see you soon.